Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In this video we start to make a saddle stop that fits the V slide on the lathe bed. With this stop you can fit a dial indicator and you can stop the saddle in the same position each time. Or use it to determine how deep you're travelling to a bore or how far you are from a face. This is the finished item. Consists of a dial indicator, block of steel with the V milled in to match the slide, a clamping bar and a brass bush to stop the dial indicator getting damaged. So let's go into the workshop and see how we make it. This is my adapter and the idea of this is it fits into the cross slide and then I can bolt the compound slide on the front there using these screws. But for this job I just need to set it square that way and clamp a part here that I'm going to mill. And I'm just setting this piece of 1-inch square bar for milling. Just set my dial indicator on the back and clocked up the back face parallel with the chuck so I know it's square. I've got a piece of packing under here to hold the bar up, a strap pulling the bar on and a piece of packing at the back so when the cutter comes along here it's not going to hit this face. And what I'm going to do is mill a small V in the bottom here. Now to set this at the right angle I've used my protractor on there with spirit level, moved it up to 45 degrees. So now I'm ready for the milling part. I'll hold the cutter in the chuck and move it across this bar to cut. That's the V we've cut out. That should go on there. This can then slide right up to the end and can stay here when not in use. All I need to do now is to face off the end square, take the sharp edges off and cut this to 3-inch. I've put my four-jaw chuck on. I've just put the block in the jaws. I'm just facing off. Just turned it around in the chuck, face the other side. I've just moved the compound slide round to 45 degrees and I want to take these sharp corners off. Tighten the corners off so that I'm not going to catch that when I'm using it. So I'm just going to run the file over these other edges, make sure there's no sharp parts. It's held on this end with the cap head still located, and where I've drilled the second hole I just want to put a mark. So I've made a mark on the material. Now I want to drill 5mm clearance. So that's the hole we just drilled, which goes down an eighth of an inch, about 4mm. And this cap head in the bar goes into there just as a location, stops it twisting. This hole is for the dial indicator, and it will have a bush inserted. The hole on the top will be threaded to take the locking screw for the dial indicator. So the way this works is, as you tighten this screw up here, this bar will clamp under the bottom of the V and hold this into position. Let's go and try it on the lathe. That goes over the V. This screw locates in the hole, stop it twisting. Tighten the block up on the top. Locks the block. You can adjust this screw underneath to get the bar parallel, but what's happening, it's clamping down here, then the force is transmitted to this screw, which acts as a pivot, so that this bar grips underneath. And then when you don't need it, you can just slacken that off, slide that along out the way. Use your lathe as normal. When you need to stop, slide it back, lock it up, and then the dial indicator will be through here. So the tip of the indicator will touch on the pad of the saddle. So the next thing I need to do is make a bush for this. So when you tighten the screw up, the bush clamps up on the outside of the indicator. I need it an inch long, but as this total piece of brass is only an inch and a quarter, I'll do half here, turn it round in the chuck, and then complete the other half. We've made this brass bush with a head on the end. The idea is that will go on there and be level with the top of the dial indicator. The brass bush will fit into there so that when it's fully home, you've still got a gap between the dial indicator and the block, and you've still got movement on the dial indicator from that side. The next job is to tap a hole in the block to take a locking screw.
bring the tool up and touch the face. Set the compound slide to zero. If I need to go 5mm deep into the bore, back the compound slide off 5mm. Now move the saddle along until the tool touches the component face. Move the block in and lock the block. Set the dial indicator to read zero. Move the saddle back and move the compound slide 5mm back to zero. So when the tool is 5mm into the bore, the dial indicator reads zero. This is useful when you're using your traverse. By checking the position of the indicator to the saddle, you can tell how deep the tool is in the bore. That's it for today. I hope that was useful. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.